National Network, in 2009, every 2 minutes, an American was sexually assaulted. We don't hear much about sexual assault crimes because, according to research, only about 60% of sexual assault crimes are reported to the police, therefore stating that only 97% of rapists never spend a day in jail. As members of the community, we must be more aware of dangers we can face and how to get help. As a female member of society, I am more at risk than a male member of society to be sexually assaulted. And learning about Denim Day helps us be informed, helps us be aware of where we can get help and how to prevent sexual assault. First, I will talk to you guys about the difference of sexual assault and rape. And second, I will share a brief story of how Denim Day started and why it started and how it helps spread awareness. Then lastly, I will share with you guys ways we can all spread awareness and ways where we can help others. So first, what is the difference between sexual assault and rape? While rape can be included in sexual assault, there are actually two different dictionary definitions to both words. In 2008, the National Network to End Domestic Violence shared an article on womenslaw.org that stated that rape is actual forced sexual intercourse. Depending on location, the definitions vary, but for the most part, that's what it is. Force can and does include being talked into, having sex. It can include, it includes being drugged or drunk, or not being able to legally give consent for sexual intercourse. And the term sexual assault is a more broad, more vague. It includes any form of sexual contact, which does include rape. Sexual assault can happen to just about anyone. That includes women, men, children, elderly, straight, or gay. Now that we have stated that rape is not always sexual assault, but sexual assault is always rape, let's move on to our second point, that is, how did Denim Day start? In order to understand why Denim Day is important and how it helps spread awareness, we must look into the background and see how it helps spread awareness. Denim Day has become a big event to the Peace Over Violence organization. It's so big that they even have a webpage for the day in particular. On their website, they have a longer, more detailed story of the history of Denim Day, but I will share a more brief one with you. So it goes that in the 1990s, an 18-year-old girl was picked up by her 45-year-old driving instructor, and he took her to an isolated area where he forcefully raped her. When she finally made it back home, she told her parents, and her parents helped her press charges against the guy. He was arrested and prosecuted, but then the case made it to the Italian Supreme Court, where the case was overturned and the perpetrator was released. A statement by the chief judge where he argued that because the girl was wearing very tight jeans, she must have helped him take off the jeans, therefore it was no longer considered rape, but consensual sex. In a matter of hours, the case results caused great chaos in the Italian Supreme Court, and women in Parliament took into action. They wore jeans to protest the results and the destructive attitudes towards sexual assault. And this act of protest got as far as coming to the United States, with Patricia Giggins, who was the executive director of Peace Over Violence, and she was the one that actually started Denim Day. The first Denim Day was in April of 1999, and for the past 15 years, Denim Day has been held on a Wednesday in April in honor of Sexual Awareness Month. Wearing jeans has become a symbol of protest for sexual assault and, like I said, destructive attitudes towards sexual awareness. After discussing what Denim Day is and how it spreads awareness, us explore ways to improve our knowledge of sexual awareness and how we can get help. While it may seem that as random college students, we can't really do much to let others know what sexual awareness is, because it is such a heavy topic, and it may seem hard to get help, but it's actually not that hard. Spreading awareness, you can do as much as being informed. You can participate in Denim Day by wearing jeans and letting others know your choice of clothing and why you chose to wear jeans. There are many hotlines, many of which you can find on the Denim Day official website. And now that we know how to spread awareness and where we can get help, it is let us wrap things up. It is important to be informed of a day such as Denim Day because we must be aware of dangers we face. We must be aware of how we can help others. First, I explained the difference between sexual assault and rape. Then I gave a brief history of Denim Day and how it's helped spread awareness. And last, I explained how we can help spread awareness and how we can get help. So now, let this sit in your mind. We spend 100 minutes in this class, meaning that for every class period that we are here, 50 Americans have been sexually assaulted.